Good morning. This is our third meditation for Holy Week, and it's entitled Night, and it relates to the events described in Luke's Gospel, chapter 22 and from verse 39. Our thoughts go again to Jesus as he faced all that lay ahead of him and what it meant to take upon himself the sin of the world. As truly God and truly man, in his humanity, he needed all the support and companionship that was available, mainly from his disciples, whom he had been with for the last 3 years. He had warned his disciples on several occasions that this time was coming, when he would be arrested and condemned to die that cruel death on the cross. Now the time had come. He had been in that upper room in Jerusalem celebrating the Passover over a meal with his disciples. Now they leave and go out to the Mount of Olives. Jesus is still reaching out to his disciples, warning them to be careful about temptation. They enter an area known as Gethsemane, where Jesus had been before. Here Jesus leaves his disciples and goes about a stone's throw away from them and begins praying to his Father. Father, if you are willing, please take this cup of suffering away from me. Yet I want your will to be done and not mine. Again he prayed more fervently, in agony of spirit, and his sweat fell to the ground like drops of blood. He then returns to his disciples and finds them asleep. Get up and pray, he tells them. What a night. Then there is a disturbance in the trees around them, and a crowd appears, led by Judas, one of Jesus' own disciples, here to betray Jesus to his enemies. They arrest him and take him to the high priest's home. Other gospel writers state that at this time all the disciples got up and fled, leaving Jesus on his own. What a night. Peter follows at a distance, watching. He sees the guards light a fire in the courtyard, with others standing around, and Peter moves toward them quietly and slips into the courtyard to join them. But he is recognized by different people who spoke up saying, "This man is also one of Jesus' followers." 3 times Peter denies that he has anything to do with Jesus. And then the rooster crowed, and Peter looked up and sees Jesus looking across the courtyard at him. He gets up and leaves, weeping bitterly at what he had just done. What a night. The guards in charge of Jesus begin mocking and beating him, even hurling insults at him. Where are his friends to help and support him in his time of need? What a night. As I read these events that unfurled one after the other, Jesus' love and compassion come shining through. Even in that upper room, his thoughts have been toward his disciples, as he showed them such a practical way in which they could remember his forthcoming death, as he took bread and wine and gave it to them, telling them that it would remind them of his body broken and his blood poured out for the sin of the world. Jesus knew what was happening to him, and he was in complete control of the situation, except perhaps when he was praying to his Father in agony of spirit, as he realized what it would mean to just not only suffer physically, but to have his loving Father turn his back on him and forsake him, as he took upon himself the sin of the world. Even after Peter denied for the 3rd time that he ever knew Jesus, I'm sure that when Jesus looked at him, it wasn't with a look of, "I told you so," but a look of love and compassion, which would eventually restore Peter to a forgiven relationship with Jesus next time he met him after his resurrection. What a night this was for Jesus. His time of pouring out his soul to his Father in prayer as he prepared for what lay ahead of him. Then his betrayal by one of his own disciples, followed by his arrest. All his disciples then get up and run away, leaving him on his own, followed by one of his closest disciples and friend, Peter, denying three times that he ever knew him. Then he is mistreated by the guards, with no one there to come to his defense. What a night for the Son of God. Oh, teach me what it meaneth, thy love beyond compare, the love that reacheth deeper than depths of self-despair. Yea, teach me, till there gloweth in this cold heart of mine some feeble, pale reflection of that pure love of thine. The Lord bless you. Amen.